that time of year!
Hey, yo, give me the list. What we got?
Yo, we got tree.
Check.
Cane.
Yes.
Hats. Music.
Uh-huh.
Nog.
Yeah.
Excuse me?
Eggnog?
You mean that putrid fucking sin liquid? Texture akin to that of cold discharge?
That's Kris Kringle's own holy nectar, you holly jolly whore!
I don't drink the semen of Satan because I like the flavor!
Eggnog not bad, you bad!
Fuck you!
Hey man, what are we doing? This isn't what the holidays are about.
It's April.
Tell you what, let's take a few steps back here. I'll have some hot chocolate, you'll have some cold cum, and together we'll watch Elves. The movie from 1998 on VHS, not the new one.
Here we are.
Get the fuck out of here.
Back again enough for another Christmas special in this. The year is... I'm gonna slow down on the Christmas themes now. It's January 4th at the time of recording, and I am nowhere near finishing this thing. And I am as good at meeting deadlines as I am at reciting the lyrics to the dream song from Sharkboy and Lava Girl, which is to say, not great. But I'm working on it. So in that video, it's not a good video, by the way, don't watch it. A friend and I talk about three Hallmark movies and meme on them a bit.
We watched over a dozen of those fucking movies to find the ones half worth talking about. A feat that has taken an unspeakable toll, both mentally and physically.
But, you know, I'm fine. So we're not gonna do that this year. Instead, I found an obscure Christmas movie from 1989. Let me tell you a little bit about this film real quick. Elves, according to the IMDb, is a film involving summoned elves, selective breeding, evil Nazi experiments, and an attempt to create a race of supermen.
Elves. They're not working for Santa anymore.
Okay, enough foreplay. Let's get this on the TV. Ah, opening credits set to spooky music and some well-lit Christmas ornaments. This isn't scary at all. So we open with three girls trudging through a forest that's so poorly lit that I had to crank up the brightness to see anything at all. The girls are here to do a thing, and it's gotta be now, because...
I know, it just feels right.
Okay.
Whatever. We have to be close to Mother Earth. Get real, Kirsten. Get over it, Amy.
Yeah, get with it, Amy. We're like performing a satanic ritual here. Like, what's your damage?
Wait, are they actually performing a ritual?
We now convene the Sisters of Anti-Christmas.
We're only 2 minutes in. It's not even a good pun. Is that the best I can come up with? Is that it?
So the girls are here to, I guess jokingly, hold a pagan ceremony in the dead of night. You know, as you do.
We're girls, remember? We're the master race. Killer.
Excuse me, ma'am, that is a very poor choice of words.
We could control everything and everyone.
Satan wasn't enough. Beelzebub Antichrist, that was good enough for you. Had to raise the bar even more than that. You know, why not? Shit, I mean, why stop there? Let's just have every evil. ISIS, KKK, CEO of Konami.
What's this? It's our symbol, the Virgin of Anti-Christmas.
What?
No, you don't understand. It's actually very clever, because later in the movie, it's revealed that the lines on the boobs are actually a hate symbol. There's no way you saw that coming, don't lie.
I don't know if you could really call this foreshadowing. It's a bit on the nose, and the eyes, And the tits! So, yeah, our introduction to this movie is a woman with blonde hair and presumably blue eyes performing a satanic ritual with her two white friends while referring to women as the master race, and it's played completely straight.
Hey, the candle.
Whoopsie! My hand slipped! Silly me! Whoops! Yeah, so the candle being broken made them all up and leave, I guess. Which is a shame, because they missed the part where the rubber hand rises from the depths, like a zombie. But it's not, it's an elf. Yeah. They split up in front of this remarkably well-lit house for it still being nighttime. Kirsten hurries on in, we briefly cut to the creature's witcher senses, and now in sight of her house.
Grandpa, I was just gonna...
What the fuck? She's like 25! Okay, first off, why does she still live with her parents? But more importantly, Jesus! Why does she get bitch-slapped? And then again, when she tries to explain herself! That looked way too real. I don't know how I feel about this.
I'm sorry. I worry.
Hey, I'm gonna walk down to the gas station. You want anything?
I'm sorry. I care about you. Yeah, so he's mad that she was out late and touched his books, I guess. Cut to the goblin's equal vision, and then to the kitchen scene.
Where have you been?
Nowhere. I was with Brooke and Amy.
The unholy trio.
He's already slapped me twice.
Well, that isn't going to stay with you.
Too close.
But this will. Your savings account is history.
Ma'am, please.
I'm going to the bank tomorrow to close it out.
You can't do that. That is so totally outrageous. I earned that money. It's mine.
Not anymore.
Cut to Kirsten in the shower, either stressing over the night's events or just thinking really hard. Her kid brother is outside. Even on her.
What are you doing?
You pervert.
I'm not a pervert. I like seeing naked girls.
I'm your fucking sister.
Yeah, and you've got fucking big tits, and I'm gonna tell everybody I saw them.
Get out of here.
You're not supposed to be in here without my permission.
Yeah,
well,
fucking mom says she's getting me.
I got nothing. What is there to say about that? Jeff, what's going on? What is this?
Moving on, the troll monster breaks into the house in the dead of night. Nobody hears that.
45-second shot of creature's detective vision before
attacking the kid, or more accurately, holding his shoulders and shaking him around a little bit before being scared away by the house cat.
Boy, now, if that doesn't give you the holiday spooks, and I just don't know what will.
This is gonna be a good video.
Next scene, nothing happens. The girls talk for a bit. It's mostly just my number one favorite thing in movies.
Hey guys, it's almost break. Let's go goof on Santa. I've been waiting for this all day.
Cool.
What kind of cut was that? Everything was normal until... Oh, it's just gremlin vision.
Hey Gavin, how are you? How you doing?
Okay, Hugh, it looks like Christmas is treating you okay. Got my 90-day shift. It was a real tough grind, but I did it.
Why don't you get some coffee and donuts at the snack counter?
Come on, Hugh. I can buy my own coffee. And you know I don't need any donuts. I need a job.
We contract out for our security now.
Look, I'm straight. You can trust me. Give me a break, please.
I'm sorry.
What'd you say?
I'm sorry.
You know, you really are sorry, Hugh.
You take that cinnamon outside, mister. It's Christmas time.
You know, Merry Christmas to you.
It's the season to be jolly. La, 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 la.
Ho, ho, ho. And what do you want for Christmas, little girl? Oral.
What?
Santa said oral.
What do you think of when you think of Christmas? For me, family dinner, presents, sexual harassment, hot chocolate, elf monster.
Nice, kitty.
Oh yeah, animal abuse.
What is this movie? Jeffrey, what's...
What's going on in there?
Trying to summarize this movie is legitimately one of the hardest things I've ever had to write. Nothing important or interesting happens, and yet there's a different absurd thing happening every 10 seconds.
Santa tells woman to eat a shit. Preacher grabs a knife.
Santa snorts cocaine.
Mother buries dead cat in pre-prepared hole.
Santa literally actually has his balls chopped off by an Xmas goblin.
And then he fucking dies from not having balls anymore.
His corpse is found, like, immediately.
So fast forward, now there's an investigation. Now we're outside, the big nameless guy is evicted. It's very sad. We play sad music. You should feel sad.
Then the munchkin is outside her window, and it's really scary. But the mom doesn't believe her.
You and your damn elves, I'm sick of it.
Fast forward to the next morning, and both our sad characters meet, and they talk and have human emotions, such as sad. Then big nameless man gets bequeathed the title of Santa. Also, he's an ex-detective, and he enters the crime scene and also finds this symbol that no one from the actual detective team noticed or thought was important. There's a symbol that the gnome leaves everywhere, and it's stupid. Green Goblin was summoned by the blood of the Virgin, who is our main character, and we know this because the Wikipedia says so. Now we're in Nazi Grandpa's room, and there are more Nazis, and they say a lot of things.
When there is no more room in hell, the elves will walk the earth.
So what I'm gathering is that hell is booked.
Yeah. Everyone who dies now becomes a goddamn goblin.
Then he pulls out a gun.
You decided nothing.
Never mind. Then nothing important happens for like 15 minutes. The girls break into the store at night and do things. Santa is there too, because he lives and sleeps at the crime scene, apparently. Then the girls and Santa, they meet up, and nothing happens still. But oh, the Nazis are here, and we don't know why. Spoilers, it's because they want to kidnap her and keep her safe. That's why they're shooting at her. And the elf is here, and he looks really good.
Mannequins are scary, right? Fuck it, just put a load of them in a dark room and then make one of them the crypt keeper. Who gives a shit?
Why bother with all that pesky effort when you can just, you know, when you can just wing it in the mall and just edit it all together in post until you reach 90 minutes?
Why make more than one elf when you can just make one elf and then call the movie Elves anyway? You know, fuck it.
So then the Nazis leave, and the gobbledygook killed one of the girls, the other is shot. I don't care. It's day now, and the authorities are here. Again.
You know, Mike, you just never learn. You're one of the best detectives in the force, and you drank your way out of that job. Now this!
Look, man, I'm telling you what I saw, goddammit. I'm telling you I saw a 2-foot elf.
Look, man, I know it looks bad that I'm carrying a gun and I'm the only witness, but I'm telling you, man, I saw a 2-foot-tall Christmas goblin. What's so hard to believe about that? Then they both get fired because the manager has no soul, and the Glubgo-Gabgolab sucks on a dead girl's fingers. Santa goes home with the girl, and the mom does not believe her still, but Santa sees the spooky symbol again, and he puts 2 and 2 together in his caveman brain and realizes that, you know, that is definitely weird that it's here as well. And then nothing happens again. I'm gonna skip around a little bit because this movie makes no sense. Santa goes to meet up with
Dr. Exposition.
And boy, does he say some crazy shit.
The little creepy things are the little creatures that creep on 2 legs. Idiomatically, we call them elves.
Somehow, this symbol Santa shows Doctor sends him into a 2-minute-long rant about Bible Genesis chapter 6. How these two things are related is never explained. There's this line in the Bible that refers to the little creeping creatures. This is a direct reference to the goblins, who Noah saved on the Ark. Also, the Nazis believed in goblins.
They believed in elves?
Oh, yes. They believed in a lot of things.
I mean, yeah, They definitely had some strong opinions.
I don't know if you know about those guys, but they were a little crazy.
So when Santa asks for more info on the Nazis, the doctor gives him a big ol' IOU. So he finds another doctor.
Why don't you tell me what you know about the elves?
Elves, my God, this is a matter of life and death.
Okay, listen up. It's very simple. There are two schools of thought. One group believes the Nazis experimented on the Gremlinoids as assassination teams, calling them perfect soldiers. The other thinks that the little men were part of a Are you with me so far? Okay, good. A genetic experiment. Each Krampus was supposed to have sperm that, when mated with a pure Aryan woman, would produce the Antichrist and also the Master Race. But it has to be done on Christmas Eve, and then they'll rule the world. Also, he explains all this in front of his 2-3-year-old daughters.
So the thing is, when that pure Aryan virgin is just getting absolutely railed by that goblin.
Daddy. What's Aryan?
Not now, honey.
And so, with this newfound knowledge, Santa sets off to stop the Nazis and kill the Gnoblin. Meanwhile, back at Kirsten's house, her mom finally comes around and believes her on the whole friends being dead thing.
You remind me of your father. You're a lot like him.
I am.
You're attractive. You're bright. You're independent. Impulsive. Self-centered. Narcissistic.
And we're back.
What are you saying? Dad's dead.
Your dad is in the study.
Grandfather is in the study.
The man in the study is your grandfather. And your father!
Apparently he had to create the perfect woman or something. It's weird.
Back with Santa, who appears to be having a tough time with the cigarette lighter. Oh! Okay. All right, you're just keeping that in your dash? You should probably take care of that, man.
Shit, I think there's a wasp in here.
Fuck. Ugh. Man, that could have been bad.
Where's Kirsten? She better be okay. Come on. Where is she? Who in the hell are you? What are you, a goddamn Nazi or something? Is that elf yours? How many teeth you got, huh? Now how many you got?
Hey, man, are you all right? What are you, some kind of goddamn fascist? Is that your goblin? What's 17 divided by 4? The correct answer is 4.25!
So then Santa takes the innocent man's car and drives away.
Deja vu.
Then the mean mom takes a bath and we get to see ass and boob. Good. Gremlo shoves the radio into her bath. Then we have the big confrontation between Nazi Grandpa and Father Christmas. It's revealed here that Kirsten is the only one who can kill the midget because the script says so. And deep down, she already knows how. Grandpa proves this by showing us the swastika boobs responsible for the age restriction. And then he gets shot.
Now that hell is full, I wonder where you will go.
No!
The boy and the girl run away. Santa gets killed, probably. The Nazis go after them and they get cornered. It all comes to this. It's the end of the line.
Stop it.
I take back everything I said about this movie. This is the best thing I've seen in my life.
So while the holiday Nazi goblin starts touching up the girl to bring about the Antichrist, the boy runs all the way back to the house, grabs the elf stone, and runs all the way back to the forest, and the goblin still hasn't gotten down to business. She could have just grabbed the stone. She even made direct eye contact with it.
I fucking hate this movie so much.
And so finally, all that's left now is for the protagonist to kill the garden gnome. Just when you thought we'd seen it all, we touched every ground. No! Just slid that gay hate right on in there. Ain't no way that'll age poorly.
just like that, the movie's over.
I would not recommend this film. It has its moments, but they're pretty few and far between. Honestly, I can't quite tell whether this movie is more of a passion project gone wrong or a soulless cash grab. Which is really ironic, considering that the movie jokingly criticizes this very thing within the first 5 minutes.
We bemoan Christmas as a petty, over-commercialized media event.
But that said, I'm just glad that, as an industry, we've moved away from that cynical, manipulative approach and really focused on capturing the spirit of the season. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go and browse through the selection of modern classics. Thanks for watching, and Merry Christmas.